go to the modifier property shelf, call up the modifier list and select Geometry Node Modifier. Change your current workspace to Geometry Nodes Editor to start building up your procedural geometry. Geometry nodes were introduced by Pablo on the official YouTube channel of Blender on 2nd December 2020. It is a new feature of Blender 2.9.2, currently on alpha state, so at the very early stage of this feature. The Blender dev team published two examples of this procedural geometry feature. Similar to the shader editor, this is a node-based version for 3D geometry. I want to show you in this tutorial where to find this function and what is the theory behind it. Basically, this function is divided into two parts with dependents, the modifier and the editor, because you will be able to create and edit the modifier itself. So where to start? Select your object, go to the modifier property shelf and find the generate nodes modifier in the generate section. So far everything is empty here. So create or use a workspace and switch to geometry nodes editor. A quick slide in, if you use more than one modifier, then it is important which one you selected at last. Your current active modifier is highlighted with this blue seam as of now. The geometry nodes editor is only available when the geometry node modifier is active. The geometry node editor is very similar to the shader editor, but you find a group input and a group output here. The input node is more or less the modifier itself, with all its settings. Currently we have 0 settings in the modifier section and in this node here. Later I will show you how to add new setting option. But this is where the modifier starts from the assigned object, the cube. It is the starting position of the chain. The group output node is what you get in the 3D viewport, when all nodes are combined here. It is always the last node of the chain and the modifier ends here. But let's add something to this chain now. With Shift A you call up the Add menu as in the shader editor or go to the Add menu button here. There you find many useful nodes which are classified to categories. In this video I will just use some of them. Starting with a simple node, go to the geometry section and select Transform. Add it to the chain. Just if you place it not directly on the chain, then you need to connect the output and input position with each other. Or pull it on the chain. Now you get those translate, rotate and scaling values. It doesn't matter where your object is located in 3D space. These values stay always the same, but you are able to adjust them. Pretty interesting, but let's add another node. The subdivision surface node, which is in the mesh category. This is 1-to-1 the subdivision surface modifier, just as a node for our construct. Adjust the level here. When you enter the mesh category again, then maybe you noticed the triangulate node. So far it doesn't matter at which position you place those three nodes. The result will be always the same. But soon this will not be possible anymore. If you check the modifier in the property shelf, then it is still empty without any setting option. This is up to you to fill it. For example, pull the level input to the empty dot in the group input node. This creates a setting option at the modifier section. It is as well possible to just drag the scale input to the group input node and modify the object without any editor. Usually you do this setup when the geometry node chain is finished. The N key hide and unhide the side menu here in the editor. You see a list of all inputs and outputs here. When you select level, then you are able to rename it for the node and modifier section option. And define a minimum and maximum value so that your modifier is not getting out of control. It is as well a nice setup when you want to give the modifier or file to somebody else. You can create a duplicate of your basic object or even modified one within this geometry node group. For this we need two new nodes, the transform node, again, and a join node, which works similar to the Boolean union function, but it is better at its performance. The setup is: pull a second connection from the group input geometry location and drag it to the second transform node. But if you try to connect the transform node with the group output node, then this happens. Only one single line can lead to this AND node. This is the reason why we need the join node now. Add the line from the first chain and the line of the second chain, and now you see your second base object. You have two different objects with two different transform nodes, and you are able to create two different transforms as well, but one chain have two additional nodes, subdivision and triangulation. Basically, there is no limit to add more and more objects. For example, I can create a duplicate of a modified state. I select this transform node and press Shift plus T to duplicate it. I place it somewhere here behind the triangulate node and connect it. Next, I duplicate the join node and connect those two chains again. Consider that it works with the previous values of the transform rotation and scale. So I can use and reuse the results of the chain and modify everything from the beginning to the end. Well, one more cool thing. I want to influence several objects in scaling and don't want to adjust every single node. So I go to the vector category and add a vector morph node. Select scale here and get access to this value. And now I connect this vector node with the scale input of another object. Now I am able to control size of both objects at the same time, and the third object doesn't get influenced. I guess the array modifier is not able to do this. This is just the beginning, and I showed you just a default example. There's so much potential in this. Feel free to start a completely new node group and switch between those two. Use this for animation by inserting keyframes. Or just add more modifiers to your object. There's no end. Please keep in mind that this is just a single cube. Thanks for watching.